Good evening, friends. I am here in front of you to have a lecture on Indian education system. What Indian education system? We have a great culture and history. In the primitive time, we followed the Guru and Shishya. That is a type of education where the people gone to the Guru, who were very very much educated, those who were having great knowledge on the Vedas. We gone to them and learned from them. They not only given the people about the theory education, but also given the practical education. That's why they succeeded in their life. Most of the people in the history time, they did war, they are participated in the war and have and had given their great role in the war. Now I will tell about the current Indian education system. This education system took into act in 1964 to 66 Education Commission recommendation. This is basically based on 10 plus 2 plus 3 concept. 10 years elementary education, 2 years 10 plus 2 year higher secondary education, and then the 3 years graduation scheme. There are some good points about our Indian education system as well as some limitation in the system. So it is very very much needed time to change or bring changes in the Indian education system, as I will brief in the lecture. So Indian education system basically following on the syllabus based studies. The majority of the schools and colleges are focusing mainly on the academic status. They are not focusing on the character building of the students, like skill development and participating them in extracurricular activities, sports and games. These all are not included all the schools and universities. Some of the schools and universities are implementing this, and they always get the trophy in the annual ceremonial events. What I want to say is the syllabus oriented studies that make the students only mugging up the topic and secure great marks. And many of the organization, government employment examination, also looking for the performance of the students only. They look for the qualification certificates attained by the students. This is the main reason why our Indian education system is not changing its way. So in the Public Service Commission examination taken by the states, they look for the qualification of the students what they get. So the mark oriented studies should come with changes in the present time, so that caliber students, caliber citizens and caliber officials we can get. I can give some several examples, like Indian armed forces consist of army, navy and air force, still lacking more than 15,000 officers. Basically, the SSB interviews look for the leadership skills in the students, in the candidates, those who comes to apply. So the leadership skills, the creative mind and other activity skill, like other than the academic skill, is lacking in the candidates. That's why these vacancies always existing from the last 15 to 20 years. These vacancies are not fulfilling, as India having more than 1.2 billion, nearly getting 1.3 billion crore of people, and our youngsters is more than 60% of population, but still this much of vacancies are existing. Why? Because the caliber of students is not well to show them as a caliber leaders. So Indian education system should give opportunity to the students to improve their interpersonal skills. So there is some suggestion. First of all, the syllabus is very vast, from the elementary education to the higher education. The vast syllabus just focus on the examinations and mark held by the students. This should be limited, and those the theory classes should also be provided with practical oriented classes, like polytechnics and Industrial Training Institute following. They are giving the practical education along with the theory education. This should be followed by the schools and colleges. Our Mahatma Gandhi, in his autobiography, The Experiment with Truth, also telling us some examples that the need of creativity and creative thinking among the students and give them quality education. But even after the death of Mahatma Gandhi, we are not following the research-oriented studies. You know, 200 rank rank best schools in the world, where Indian, no any Indian universities is formed. So it is again a difficult task for our universities to come under the 200 merit rank of the world. So what we can do is give more importance to the research oriented, practical oriented studies, so that the students can feel themselves very capable and to give more to the towards national building. So this is about the practical syllabus. Second is the teachers to students ratio. This is also very limited. In public school, you can see one teacher is taking a class of more than 50 to 60 students in a class. How a single teacher can monitor the performance of almost all this much of students? That's why many of the people are sending their children to the private institutes. The ratio of government schools with the private school is 7:4. This is very much rising today, and people are not willing to send their children to the government schools. The second thing is the syllabus they are following in the state government and the central government is different than that of the private schools. Private schools and the central government school is following NCERT syllabus, and state government following their own syllabus. This also making an isolation in between the state and the central government education. So the people having well economic background sending their children to the private schools, and those having the poor background sending their children to the government school. This isolation should also be negated. What we can do is considering a unique syllabus, either it is NCERT based or other, but unique system should be followed in all Indian institutes, whether it is public or private. Next is the next problem is the extracurricular activities which is focused on the school education. The children should be given time to participate in games and sports. Why India is lagging behind many other countries like China, Russia and America? We collectively got gold medal from independence to 2018. A collective gold medal race of India is still less than the gold medal secured by America and China in a single world event. In Asian Games, they got more than 200 gold medals, and from after independence to 2018, we did not secure 200 gold medals. So what this shows that the participation of students in sports and games is very much limited. Parents are not giving priority to sports and games. What we can change, how we can change is the syllabus system, Indian education system, that should be given priority to the sports and games events in their syllabus, so that it is automatically supported by the government, by our system. More students, we have more potential in our youth. They will definitely come and participate, but it is not in the syllabus, that's why they are not coming. By including this on the syllabus, by giving marks for the sports and game activities, the participation of the youth will be increased. So this problem also can be negated. So now come to the crime cases existing in the India. Several crime cases are increasing in our country. Not only the crime cases, but also the unlawful activities also increasing. This is also a second impact or production of bad education system we are following. Our people, those are victims of these crimes, are not ready to report to the police. And those who are the perpetrators, those seeing the incident, they are also not reporting to the police. So first of all, it is unawareness, what are the legal levels they can be followed. This is not taught by any education system. Second, the moral stamina, the moral courage is also lacking in the community. So these should also be given in the syllabus of the Indian education system. A moral lesson to be included, so we can make the students more caliber, and these students now again in the future become the people of the country, citizen of India. So they will perform their duties very well. There are fundamental duties and fundamental rights, and more than 50% of the people are unaware about this, and they are not performing up to the expectation of the government. This can also be negated by enhancing the syllabus system of our education system. So finally, I want to conclude, like the limiting the syllabus by enhancing the teachers and students ratio, by coming up with a unique syllabus system and giving more focus on the research and practical based studies, and giving more education on the moral values, and increasing participation towards sports and game events and yoga, like this, we can give, or we can produce more citizens. They are not only well in their academic standard, but also well in their stamina, moral, courage, everything. So we can bring more quality citizen in our country, and we can emerge into a developed nation. Thank you.